Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to Let's Really Ghost Thief 2. I have time to do two missions today. That's really exciting. Ambush is also a very, very short mission. It's up next. As always, the briefing has been separately uploaded, so let's begin. Here are objectives. Escape the ambush and return to your home in the northwest and don't kill anyone. Pretty straightforward. This is a mission where I'm told it's possible to perfect Supreme it if you skip a pickpocket, which means I'm going to perfect Thief it with a bust getting that pickpocket. But I should be able to do the rest of the mission without but violating any Supreme rules. So, let's get started.
Before they see me.
There's no opportunity to make purchases here. Obviously, we're escaping an ambush. But if you're going after the pickpocket, you want to immediately leave the spot where you start and come to this nook instead. What you have to do is wait for these two patrollers to sort of sync up, which they'll do because their distances are staggered, or you can go for it all at once, whatever your preference is. I like to kind of rush it.
What?
Since first alerts are inevitable anyway if you go for that, but there it is. Only first alerts. Back inside the crippled Burrick, we find this note. Watch Sergeant Harwin. I must protest that the technique of paying informants has been in place for only a week, and I think it has shown far more promise than expected. While the first round netted us only a few small fish, the fools have begun to compete to turn each other in. A good fraction of the gold we pay out, we reap back again when we arrest the informers themselves. Ceasing the project now would be, in my opinion, short-sighted. Morgan. There you go. This mission's pretty bare bones, which is the one thing I don't like about it. I like to move that body, just in case it triggers alerts when people see it. That was the first of 8 pickpockets, by the way. This is a mission with 0 secrets, and it ends up with a total of 1,970 gold, but there's very, very little loot to be found, even though I know that sounds like a lot. I'll explain why. Much like Escape in Thief Gold, in this mission, we'll find a purse that contains everything we took in the last mission. And there's very, very little loot to find besides that purse. I like the big open map in this mission.
I think next time, I better say no to that second mug of coffee.
I like...
Hey, was something just there?
I like the opportunity to escape a lot of tight patrols, but... The city really feels empty. That's the problem. The map is very skeletal. That's what I don't like. So anyway, we got in and out with only first alerts, as you saw. That's worth our first real save, I think. Because that's one of really only 2 trouble spots we'll have in the entire mission. And it's worth noting, too, that first alerts in there are the only Supreme busts we have to take. If you want to skip that pickpocket, it's possible to perfect Supreme Ghost the entire mission. Here's a conversation.
What's going on? The city watch are all over the place.
Oh, they're looking for some guy the sheriff once brought in.
Goodness me, is this man dangerous?
They say they want him dead or alive, but it looks to me like they'd prefer dead.
And how do you know that?
I was at the pub, saw a couple of bluecoats ambush the guy there. He managed to get away, though. Never seen anyone move that fast before. He just vanished into the shadows.
My!
Yeah, I'm awesome, what can I say? So, you just want to mantle up here. There are 2 water arrows and a moss arrow in this garden, if you want them. Go ahead and go through this door. Just make your way through this window and slide down to the ground. It's possible to do so silently and with no damage. Now, you'll want to immediately head over here to get another pickpocket. It's easiest to wait for the swordsman to turn his back. And then if you get up right next to him and lean, you can pickpocket the arrows off of the archer. Like so. No problem. There's our second of 8 pickpockets. Now, before we leave this area, we want to get the loot out of the gate control tower. So I'm going to wait for these two guys to turn around, and then I'm going to follow them. Let's take this opportunity to look at our map. We've got a pretty detailed map of the city streets, which is nice, but it isn't that useful because you don't really know where the patrols and guard stations are. So you have to find ways around them, but you can see that to get home, we start at the pub in the southeast, we work our way through the marketplace, Helena Way, Sparrow Street, Hill Street, up to the northwest corner where our home is. Up north, we have a graveyard, which we won't get to in this mission, but we'll revisit this map later and go there in a different mission. And over here, we have Shale Bridge Road with an old gate leading to Shale Bridge. Ignore Shale Bridge for now. You end up over there later. I'll explain more then, but for now, we're just going to make our way northwest through Helena Way and the Marketplace and Hill Street and home. We'll have most of the loot before we even go home. They will alert to doors opening, so just be careful. Let them build up a respectable distance. Nothing in this mission can be relocked, so we don't have to worry about that. But we pick open this door. Now that door on down the stairs you want to avoid, that'll dump you right out in front of all the guards at the pub where we just came from. But up here, stay crouched because people can see you through the windows. That lever opens the gate inside the tower underneath us. We're not interested in that key. That's 3 noisemaker arrows we're also not interested in, but we do want these coins. Worth 25. Bring our total to 25. Awesome. Now, we need to get around these guys again.
What's that?
And we have to wait a little bit on them, which is fine. And then slip out the door. Now, they'll bump into us if we try to hide in that shadow. At least they bumped into me before, but this is a good, perfect shadow where we can just wait for them to go by and then head into the marketplace. Ah, the wonders of perfect shadows. Now, there are 2 possibilities here. I've seen an AI here behave in 1 of 2 ways. One of them makes the mission very easy. One of them makes it very difficult. I'll explain the solutions for both outcomes, but obviously I'm hoping to only have to demonstrate the very easy one. Up this staircase, before we get started with that, is a purse worth 50, brings our total to 75. Now, something happened to my controls. Ah. I accidentally hit caps lock. That's what happened to my controls. What the F is going on? Garrett seems to be... I don't know what this is. I don't like it, I'll tell you that. Well, something's the matter with my controls, and I don't know how to fix it, so I'm gonna have to back up a little bit. Well, that didn't help. I'm sorry, folks. I may I may have to go ahead and restart the game. Oh. Now it's fixed. Okay, good. So here's the AI.
What's a big fella like you doing out here at night? Don't you want a woman to keep you warm?
What for? This uniform is plenty warm enough, and it's not even cold out tonight.
Now, I've seen her stop in two different positions. Let's see what she does. It looks like we have drawn hard mode. Sometimes she stops facing the window with her back to the marketplace. That makes things very easy. We drew hard mode this time. So, easy mode doesn't even need an explanation. Since I have to do hard mode, I'll show you how it's done. But for now, we just need to cross the marketplace. There's a bunch of food lying around. I think there are 12 total food items if you want them. Obviously, I'm not interested in any of that. Or, no, I'm sorry. I was thinking of the grocery store. There's nothing inside the marketplace. So, you can cross the marketplace without a first alert, but you have to really stay flush with the lamppost and not move fast enough to up the brightness on your light gem. Usually, the place where you get alert is when you squirt free and get around the corner, like that. But looks like I could well make the crossing on my first try, which would be great. Well, I guess I'm lying if I say it's my first try. I played this mission once before I recorded the video, while I was waiting for Framed to upload. Seemed like a good use of my time. I have cranked the gamma a few points, and this mission is still absurdly dark. I apologize for that. I mean, I noticed that Framed looked a lot brighter and was easier to see, so I think they just neglected to properly light the city at large, but even though it's too dark to see, I'll tell you where I'm going. You see the guard facing the marketplace. I'm headed to the southwest corner where there's a way out. It is worth noting that if you want to jump to the fountain, you can find 5 water arrows in there. I'm taking the southwest street out of the marketplace and heading to this apartment. Right here. Up these stairs, there are 2 pieces of loot and some reading material. The apartment's extremely dark too, but at least we can fix that by turning on some lights. So there are some copper coins in baby's room, worth 5, bring our total to 80. Reading material in the front room, I guess. My lord, I write to thank you for your most interesting entertainment of the other night. The sheriff's men are, as you said, most efficient, and watching the rabble fall over themselves in panic afforded me more entertainment than a good month of theater. Might we avail ourselves of this street-cleaning farce again this weekend? I await your reply, your devoted L. And then, in the bedroom, you can find a gold goblet worth 25, which brings your total to 105. And although I'm not particularly interested in it, well, actually, I think this chest might be empty. Yeah, it is. I'll turn the lights on purely so you could see. Turn them off as I leave. Head out the way we came and get down into the sewers. Down and dirty.
Sewer never looked so appealing.
Yeah, Garrett sounds stressed, but for a coordinated ambush by the sheriff, they really don't seem to be covering a whole lot of ground. It's very, very easy to sneak around this mission. But maybe it's supposed to be. Do be careful of splashing here. If people are around, they can hear it. You can't crouch because the water's too deep, but If you use your shift key to move slowly through it, you should be fine. Now, when you get to this W with the three torches on it, if you look down at the bottom of the canal, there's a purse. It's worth a lot. It's worth 200 and brings our total to 305. Which is awesome. You want to... Ah, yeah. He spotted me. Because he turned around. So if you can make it here before he turns around, there's a nice shadow right here. Ideally, you want to wait until he's headed back to the east, and then just mantle out of the canal at this low point. I'm going to wait until that's the case. I think he's headed back east now. Worry about that. There's stuff over there that I'll worry about later. For now, I'm content to move northwest toward Hill Street. Now, you want to be on this side to avoid patrols. Again, I apologize. This mission is absurdly dark. I think those two just first alerted, so I'm going to have to reload. Anyway, get on the north side of the canal at this street light, and then head north. And get into this niche. Wait for those two to turn around, and run up and nick the healing potion from the guy in back. Now, I'm going to hold on to that. I need it later. Believe it or not. So I'll return it to his patrol route at the end. That healing potion was our third of 8 pickpockets. Now, I'm waiting for a couple more patrollers from farther northwest, but maybe I can get to the next shadow. Well, there isn't another shadow. What do you know? Yeah, I'm gonna have to reload. My initial plan was solid. Wait for those two patrollers. And then follow them to the west. Actually, I don't need this healing potion. I'll return it as I cross this patrol route. I think I may have... Yeah, it sounds like those two are on their way back. So I'll have to wait for them to turn around again. Okay. I discovered that potions drop silently, unlike keys, so returning them is much easier. Now, despite the bright light, this is a good spot to wait, as long as they're headed east. We just want to get the arrows from the archer in that pair of patrollers. That will be our fourth pickpocket. Grab those arrows, get across the street. That's our fourth of 8 pickpockets. And now we're gonna head to the grocery store. That door sometimes disappears, so be watchful for that. Here there are 12 pieces of food, if you're interested, and there are also 7 pieces of loot on the counter, all various forms of coinage. When you grab them all, our total is 442. Awesome. Good, no disappearing door. From here, there are a couple more things I'm not really interested in. There are some broadhead arrows in an apartment here on Helena Way. And if you go to Sparrow Street, south of here, you can find a toolbox inside of which are 3 moss arrows and the unnamed infinite arrow, which is a glitch that I'm not sure anybody quite knows what it's supposed to be. Just get back to the spot we waited last time. This time, when they get past us, we're gonna slip behind them and head west towards home. As we get up here, go past the graveyard entrance, just head straight north until you get to your apartment, get some new objectives, and listen to the conversation.
Home sweet home.
Remember, men, his name is Garrett. Consider him armed and dangerous. The sheriff wants him brought in, dead or alive.
What's the sheriff want with a common thief? Why all the extra manpower?
Truett says this man is very dangerous and clever. Just follow your orders.
But why?
I don't want to hear it. You have your orders.
Yes, sir.
Wait for her to turn and face front. Let's check out our new objectives. Several members of the City Watch are waiting for you in your apartment. You need to find shelter elsewhere, and there's no better place than Shalebridge. The only snag, you have to sneak into your home and get the gate key you keep hidden in the secret compartment in your bedroom closet. After you get the gate key, proceed to Shalebridge. Between the sheriff's patrols and the guard post at the main gate, it's not going to be as easy as it sounds. So, I did an annotation to this effect in my first playthrough, that we spent 4 hours in shipping and receiving, paying our rent on this place. Now we have to leave it all behind. It's devastating. Anyway, the first thing I'm going to do is get the arrows from the archer at the front door. This is actually pretty easy to do. If you just creep along the wall leading up to the front door right here, you'll reach a point where you can lean forward and get the arrows even though you can't see them, without getting into the visual range of the archer. And hopefully without triggering any first alerts from anyone else.
Nobody better be
Well, that time I accidentally opened the door instead of getting the arrows. Opening the front door sends these trigger-happy folks.
You hear that? Nobody better be taffing around.
Into second alert mode. Come on. Why can't I get his arrows?
Was that you?
What's over there?
I want your arrows.
Jordan?
There?
Hey, that you? Did you notice anything?
Yeah, he's got them, so let's get them. Let's try not to accidentally open the door this time.
Who'd I see there?
And you have to put them away right away. Right away with the tilde key.
You hear
Let's
that?
See what?
Oh. This is turning out harder than my trial run.
Getting tired of going after these poor slobs.
You hear that?
What's over there?
Obviously, we can't open the front door.
This one is not a hole.
think that was anything over there.
Hey,
let's see what. Was that you?
I'm having some unanticipated trouble with something that was easy my first go round.
Let's see what that was. Was that you
over there?
No.
Man, she is.
Let's see what that was.
She is trigger happy going into alert mode from an open door. My goodness.
Sure. Let's see what that was.
I assure you, this is possible because I did it last time.
Let's see what that was.
All right, snagged him that time, but that was with a first alert. Prefer to avoid that. So let's be quick.
Jordan,
I hate.
Don't want to open the door, G.
Getting tired of going after these poor slobs. Didn't do much.
Perfect. So grab them and immediately let go of the lean key. Put them away. So, after that unanticipated little hiccup, which still really wasn't that bad, those arrows are our fifth of 8 pickpockets. So head back here. Now we have to time the firing of a rope arrow to avoid an alert. Just really, we want to wait until her footsteps sound quiet. That's the best we can do. If we don't hear anything, then we're good. I've noticed that generally speaking, the female guards seem a lot more alert than the men do. Slip into the top floor, which is pitch black. I'm sorry about that. When you see her leaving, you have some time. Let's creep down
the stairs.
Looks
like I'm gonna need a new address, but I'm gonna have to get to my stash first.
If you lean into the door, when you hear his footsteps change from wood to carpet, that's a good indication that he's far enough away to open it without a first alert. So, we've returned home, we've completed that objective. We move in here, I'm gonna shut the bedroom door so I can turn my light on. And head into the closet, hit the far left hanger. Behold Garrett's stash.
Good. Now time to relocate.
So there's the Shalebridge gate key. That objective is complete. And there are lots of goodies in here. I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 water arrows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 moss arrows. 1, 2, 3 fire arrows. I think this is 10 broadheads, if I remember right. 2 healing potions. 5 noisemakers. Speed potion, slow fall potion. Scouting orbs. Anyway, not interested in any of it. I am interested in this purse, which contains however much loot you got from Framed. For me, that's 1,378, which brings my loot total to 1,820. So, shut the stash. Close the closet. Turn the light back off. And let's sneak back out. Couldn't have timed that better if I tried. Wait until he's walking away. Slip out, close the door behind you. and get back to the top floor. Slip out silently. Now this drop, it takes a little bit of luck to get it without damage, but just stay crouched and kind of try to bounce from the stone wall back to the scaffolding, and you can end up on the ground with no damage at all, like I just did. I'm gonna do a real save here. And now, we want to sneak back. A pretty long way, actually. Just blow past there, nothing to worry about. And here, I'm gonna wait until I see the swordsman archer pair so I can follow them out of here. Of course, there's always a concern that they might be shut down because of distance. So I'm going to quick save and run out. That should get them moving. I think they were shut down by distance. Good, here they come. So I'll follow them out. I'll head back the way I came. For a little while. There are already only two pieces of loot left to get, if you can believe that. So now I'm gonna wait here until they're headed back west. Get back down to Helena Way. Do need this.